Hey guys, what's up? So I've been researching for ways in order to boost the Ally performance. So in today's video, I'll show you how I improved performance and reduced the likelihood of micro stuttering. All those techniques I'm about to show are 100% safe and won't break your system in any way. So let's get started. First off, go to Google and search for MSI Utility V3. You will find this link from Guru3D Forum, which talks about the difference between line-based versus message signal-based interrupts, also known as MSI. The article is so interesting, I recommend that you read it, but basically, line-based interrupts use dedicated interrupts lines to send signals to the CPU, while MSI use data messages to signal interrupts, eliminating the need for dedicated lines. So here MSI has the advantage of scalability and efficiency. Also in the article, there is this MSI tool link. Install this MSI tool. When you open it up, you will see your hardware components, such as the audio, USB, and other stuff. But our target is the Radeon GPU. Make sure the MSI checkbox is toggled on because it means it's working by MSI standard. On the right side, you will see interrupts priority is set to undefined. Click on menu and choose high. To explain this, interrupt priority refers to the order in which a processor responds to different interrupts requests. Higher priority interrupts take the priority over lower ones. By assigning a high interrupt priority to the GPU, that ensures that the graphics-related tasks are processed quickly, leading to reduced lag or stutters. So once you are done, don't forget to press the apply button to confirm your changes. And this is one-time use tool, so you don't need to open it again unless you reinstall Windows. Now on to the second thing. Go again to Google and search for ISCL tool. It will show this great tool called Intelligent Standby List Cleaner. This tool will monitor and clear memory standby list. And if you are wondering, what's a standby list? It's basically a list of pages that were recently unloaded from working memory but are kept in standby to be quickly recalled if needed again. These pages reside in the system RAM. As for why clearing them gives better gaming experience, first you are freeing up RAM that can be used immediately by game, especially in RAM demanding games. So having as much free RAM as possible can benefit performance. Secondly, preventing disk swapping. If a game needs more RAM than is currently available, Windows will start moving some data from RAM to the SSD, a process known as paging or swapping. If you have already cleared the standby list, there's a better chance the RAM the game needs will be available immediately, reducing the need for this slow swapping process. And this will be beneficial, especially if you are allocating 8GB VRAM for the GPU. You are left with 8GB of RAM and it might not be enough in many modern games. So let's download the tool and run it as admin. In the dashboard, you can see the total system memory. In my case, it's 8GB, since I'm giving another 8GB to the GPU as VRAM. It also shows the standby list and working state. You can see now it's over 1GB and it will go even higher. As for my free memory, it's only about 2GB. That's really low and calls for action. You see there is a purge standby button. If I press it, it will clear the list and therefore gives more free memory, which is good. But as time goes, it will increase back, so we need to automate it. Down here, you can specify the app to automatically purge standby list if these two conditions apply. I'll set the size of list to be at least 1MB, so in this case, we'll have free memory as much as possible. But the second condition should apply. I'll specify if I have less than 4GB of free RAM, it will do that action. Otherwise, it's not an alarming situation and the app will not interfere. And what's cool about this tool is that you can automate it even further by starting it with Windows to work by itself. So it's set it and leave it. Also, you can change the wanted timer resolution in MS. So I'll change it from 1ms to 0.5 to be more responsive. Also, make sure to check the enable custom timer resolution for that to apply. And change the ISLC polling rate from 1000ms to 500ms. So finally, I'll press start to initiate it and you can see immediately it's not letting standby list size more than 1MB. Therefore, we have more free RAM for gaming. Now that we are done from here, let's close window and get over to Device Manager in Control Panel. Navigate to system devices because we'll need to disable some of them that could impact performance, starting with high precision event timer. While HPET can provide highly accurate timestamps and can be used by software or hardware components, however, in some humble hardware power such as the Ally, HPET can cause performance issues in games, and disabling it has been known to improve FPS and reduce stutter for many gamers out there. Let's also disable Microsoft Virtual Drive Enumerator. This one is related to managing virtual drives. Usually, as gamers don't need virtual drives running while playing, disabling it can free up a bit of system resources, as well as NDIS Virtual Network Adapter Enumerator. This one deals with virtual network adapters. Like virtual drives, virtual network adapters are not typically needed for gaming. Finally, disable Remote Desktop Device Redirector Bus, which allows remote access to your PC. When gaming, it's unlikely you'll need remote access, and disabling this one can prevent potential performance hits. When you want to disable it, it will ask you to restart your PC, but don't do that just yet, we still have some stuff to do. Leave the Device Manager and go to Registry Editor. Here we will modify some keys. Go to Software, Microsoft, Windows NT, Current Version, Multimedia, and System Profile. Here it changes system responsiveness from 14 to 1. The benefit to boot it to 1 gives higher priority to games. By changing this value, you are telling Windows to prioritize multimedia, which includes gaming processes, over almost all other tasks. That applies especially if other processes are competing for CPU utilization. Now still in System Profile, go to Tasks and here navigate to Games, and change the following keys. Set priority from 2 to 6. This will give more priority for gaming tasks. Also change scheduling category from medium to high and SFIO priority as well, which stands for Storage IO Priority. Now go back to the beginning and this time go to System, Current Control Set, Priority Control, and change Win32 priority separation from 2 to 1. This will give more priority to running foreground processes. When you are in game, basically you are in foreground. Therefore, this ultimately gets priority by CPU. Alright, we are all done from Register Editor. And for some extra optimization, in Start menu, go to Display Settings and then go to Graphics. Here, make sure you have the optimization for windowed game option activated. Then go to the Gaming tab and click on Game Mode. Also, make sure that Game Mode is activated here as well. By default, it should be on, but just to make sure we are on the same page. For the final change, I'll go ahead and disable Global C-State using Smokeless tool. If you are unsure how to do that, check my previous video here where I show step by step how to turn it off. The reason for disabling it is because C-State makes processor go through different power stages between sleeping and working. That variability causes inconsistent performance. That's why it's advisable by many to turn it off if you want to reduce stuttering and gain some extra FPS. If you followed all steps, congratulations for doing so. Now restart the system and while it's rebooting, let's watch some comparison. But first, I want to show my power limits in Armory Crate. I have a manual profile with all limits set to 30 watt and a flat fan curve of 100%. First, I'll start with Forza Horizon 4. The results are in. We saw an increase across all metrics, from zero stutter count to higher FPS and a small reduction to latency. And we are just getting started. Let's switch over to Age of Empires 2 Definitive Edition. We'll be right back. And here throughout the benchmark, we saw a higher average FPS by 3. Also, the final score increased by a bit. Now things will get even more interesting in the next and final test. I downloaded this Minecraft benchmark map that uses a lot of simulations and objects. It's made for benchmarking purpose. Shout out to the creator, Gamer Potion, for this amazing map. Now let's see the difference in real time, shall we? Here graphs speak for themselves. We see less transition from green to red, less latency, and also higher average FPS by about 7 to 8. So I will say those 2 weeks we have done had a good impact. I hope you found them useful. Let me know your thoughts in the comments, and if you like my content, please subscribe to my channel as I'm working on more 2 weeks and optimization videos for the Ally. See you in the next one.